of skinny punks that this wind doesn't pick up, because I'll come over there and jam an oar up your ass.
So now we're going to talk about, we're going to watch this little video. This is in relation to Dust. It actually is part of the reason why Dust actually, for his next birthday, has decided he might fight what the Navy instilled in him a long time ago, and he might just go for it. So Nick, show this manly, aggressive military video from the 80s, man. This is so manly. Amazing. Keep the volume down. Volume down a bit.
Our future. We invest in the technology of tomorrow while you serve your country in the Navy of today. You are ours. You are
Doc, I think this is the one that got me in. This is the one that I saw and called and was like, somebody get me in now. These guys are having way too much fun, and they're wearing G-strings jumping out of helos. Sign me up.
Come on, bro. For those just listening, we just watched an 80s commercial for the Navy where it featured men slow dancing, a man diving off a diving board with a Greg Louganis special modified G-string. You know what I mean? Bro, the zestiest Navy. And there's a lot of zesty Navy commercials. You know, a lot of them. This is what I wonder, right?
Yeah.
Like, did they realize that that's something that's a little more, you know, prevalent in the Navy and decide, yo, marketing. Like, we're going to market. Even though they didn't accept gay people in the Navy then as much, openly, did they still market the gay people?
Because you don't see that in, I mean, are we wrong? I haven't been through a lot of Army or Marine ones, but I think you're fucking right. They had a good song.
Right?
It's a little more bubbly. It's a little more, that thing could pop off in a nice alternative club. In between a share song and everybody get to bump and grind and putting a little, you know what I mean? Putting a little pelvic on pelvic situation.
Oh, bro, that's definitely, like, there's definitely been some members of the Navy that did the Chinese finger trap with their peckers to that song, for sure. Slow dancing, listening to Patrick Swayze's song from Dirty Dancing, his one original song.
That's a hot song,
like
bro.
The Wind. He's like the wind. Or a Navy SEAL is dick in my mouth. She's like the wind. And I put that dick way down south. And she's like the wind. Have that Navy man open his mouth. And then we'll go for a swim. Something, something, something. Yes, that's all I had. You know what I mean? That's all I had at the moment.
That's a beautiful. Yeah. It's a beautiful thing being in the Navy and just coming up and just tossing a man's salad, dude. It's beautiful, man. There's nothing like it. I mean, you're with your dogs all day. You're fighting for America. Okay. Yeah. Listen, I want everybody to go down and join the Navy right now. Okay. This is Dust recruiting message to young 18-year-old men. I want you to go down. You don't know nothing about your sexuality, and I don't either. But here's what you need to know: is that you need to be sexually active. Why don't you join the Navy? Fight for America. And also, you know what I mean? Have somebody touch your naughty after you guys are done fighting the terrorists and other bad guys around the globe.
Making me emotional, bro.
Also, I mean, you will get free pizza from the recruiter, and that's everything else, you know, beside the point. You can milk that for at least a summer, you guys. And they will come pick you up. They will come pick you up. And I mean, it's a patriotic thing. It's a patriotic thing, Cliff, and I appreciate your patriotism and a patriot salute to you, sir. And also
That's part of boot camp. Isn't that part of boot camp? Like, or Navy boot camp's a little different. It's like they do a little bit of like running and jumping, but like the main thing they make you do, you have to toss a certain amount of salads in a day. You have to practice giving blowjobs underwater.
Yes.
You know, it's like more like this? I have a couple friends that were in the Navy that actually I almost took an underwater blowjob from a Navy man one day, but that's a story for another day.
Nothing wrong with that. I like to.
It's a story.
There's nothing wrong with being in this. You're swimming already. You already got your skin to skin contact. That's your boy. You grew up with them, for God's sakes. Why don't you tell Absolutely. Them off? Come on.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I agree. And I think that's solid marketing. I also think it's very it's very misleading marketing because they didn't want gays then. And meanwhile, they were like, hey, gays, what are you doing? Come on, join the Navy. Do you hear the song? Do you see the bathing suit? You see that? You know, Greg Louganis, the diver? Yeah, we're just like him.
You know what I mean? There was maybe a gay at the top that was like, that thought it was so hilarious. They're like, they won't let us in. They won't let us be ourselves and fight for America like a true patriot, a homosexual American would do. A patriot?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then he goes, watch this shit. And he drops these bars on him. And he has these guys jumping on the helicopters looking thick and tight.
The agenda. It's like the agenda. You know how they always talk about the gay agenda in hip hop? You know what I mean? It's the gay agenda. They're trying to make our kids suck dick. You see this gay agenda going on, don't you? They're trying to make our kids have anal sex. You see little Nas X? He's part of the gay agenda. So maybe it was the gay Navy agenda. You know what I mean? It was some, you know, like you said, a gay at the top, as you said. I would imagine it would say that on his desk, like on his plaque. People
yes.
walk in his office, gay at the top. You know what I mean?
GATP. Or gay, what is it? Gay at the GAT. I guess it would be the acronym, if you will.
Since 2011, let's think about this. Since 2011, openly gay, lesbian, and bisexual men and women have been permitted to serve in the military. Bro, 2011. Every time we talk about things and we look at things, it just constantly reminds me that we are not anywhere near where we think we are as far as being civilized, good.
Doug, when
10
I was
years
in,
ago? 10 was, years
I,
ago.
I was in 97 to 01, and Gerardo, Petty Officer Gerardo, and
the gayest name. Bro, the gayest name. The gayest name.
He had the most Gerardo mustache. Just picture Gerardo's mustache, and that's what it was. And he had it looked like he was being undercover, which he was. He had a wife and all that good stuff. And then there was a third petty officer kid. What was his name? Like Jeremy or some shit out of Phoenix. I knew he was from Phoenix. But he goes like this. He goes, yeah, I'd wake up and he's just giving me oral. He's just topping me off. Doug. And then he says, Doug Cliff, he goes, yeah, man, like after the fourth time, you know, it was like, I mean, I can't believe it. Like I had to go report it. And I was like, after the fourth time, like, so you're waking up the first, and he goes, yeah, I was just groggy. I didn't know. I thought it was a nightmare. God,
bro.
I thought it was a nightmare.
And then what? Then you woke up and you were like, bro, what are you doing? But don't stop.
He was getting, and then I seen him. God, they put him in prison. They put him in, like restriction. They didn't put him in prison. They put him in like they took him out of his normal work and until you're getting discharged though. Like, so he got kicked out for this. Both of them did.
For blowing you? For blowing you?
No, not me. For Jeremy. I seen him, bro. I seen him and I go, God damn, I knew that motherfucker. I knew both you motherfuckers was funny.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I just knew they were both funny. Either way. The one would always try to be taking people home, inviting them too much and not in like a good way where you're like, I know you're tight, bro. You're like the old dude in the neighborhood that always tried to take the kids that didn't have pops and shit over to their pad. It was the same.
Now, here's my question. Were they like regular or were they like, you know, like the version of like how a man is with a woman, like sexual predator status?
I mean, yeah, it was like, cause this guy had a husband or a wife. He was married with children, the older guy. He was like 40. And then there was a young buck, Twink, but didn't portray himself Twink. He portrayed him. I seen him with girls.
Yeah, yeah.
Not a tight boy, but, you know, but I've been to bars with him and been out with him. You know what I mean? He'd be in the group sometime. And, but he was portrayed himself as straight, as a straight man.
But what I'm saying is, though, were they regular in their offers of gay stuff, or were they like aggressive about it? Like if they got drunk, would they start just grabbing dicks and like putting fingers up asses, like woo, like
just like it. Just taking it? Yeah, I've never seen no shit like that. No, these guys were professional, you know, dudes. The youngster was like a scumbag. He was always a scumbag.
PGs. They call them PGs, professional gays.
Yeah. When you're PGs. Married and then you go, you go under the, So that would be the older cat. The older dude that was sucking him off.
And wrap it up. Wrap that shit up, B.
Yeah.
All right. Our producer's moving us along. Where we going next, Nick Cage?
I've seen enough. Shut it down. Bury the hatch. Sell the land. And dispose of him. This never happened.
Illegal!